We all know what malaria is and what it has done to humanity and what it continues to do, especially in some part of the world that we come from. We admit a lot of progress has been made, but somehow there are still gaps that we haven't plucked completely.
The main objective of this study was to fuel the discussion about malaria elimination and provide an on-the-ground experience and views from those working on malaria at a country level.
Many we talked to felt there is a great danger of malaria slipping down the donor agenda. There is a danger of complacency. Complacency is simply unacceptable for a disease that is still killing a child every 2 minutes.
We need to accelerate our efforts in research and development in utilizing the armory that we have in order to finally end malaria for good. We indeed will invest more than $100 million into advancing research and development, and we also commit to strengthening and contributing to strengthening the capacity in sub-Saharan Africa and beyond.
One of the most important elements is keeping malaria high on the political agenda. And the countries that have the highest burden, such as Nigeria, DRC, Mozambique, Angola, are also the ones that have recorded the highest financial gap and the highest gaps in terms of coverage of core interventions.
The right combination of things needs to be done, both of prevention and then hopefully, as we see, the need to treat going down, but you're able to switch funding around from one form to another. I think all of this, though, has to be underpinned by, I mean, what we would sort of describe as a revolution in data, because part of the issue is belief in the data, the quality of the data that is there, coming from the health management information systems in the countries where we can actually find the realities of the disease on the ground.
I think one of our challenges is to structure malaria investment so that it does help to build the strength of the health system and it can be demonstrated to do so. So measuring our impact not only on malaria, I think will be critical to sustain the levels of investment that we need in order to complete and finish the malaria job.
I think these events are really important. I think one for the research that they show, especially this report, which shows the voices and the opinions of those on the front line of fighting malaria in Africa, and the events themselves for bringing the different partners together to discuss these issues and work through them to find the solutions we need to progress in the fight against malaria.
Also really refreshing to hear points of view from the main countries affected and not from just one voice, to hear kind of results from such a wide spread of countries.
And malaria is a disease, as soon as you take your foot off the gas pedal, it comes roaring back. So events like this are critical to bringing together the community and helping to galvanize further support and political will, because together we can end malaria, but we can't take progress for granted.